أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم سورة القريش آية number 1 to 4 سورة القريش is a Makki surah. It was revealed after سورة التين. It has 4 verses, 17 words and 73 حروف. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم لإيلاف قريش. For the accustomed security of the Quraysh. إِلَافِهِمْ رِحْلَةَ الشِّتَاءِ وَالصَّيْفِ. Their accustomed security in the caravan of winter and summer. فَلْيَعْبُدُوا رَبَّ هَذَا الْبَيْتِ. Let them worship the Lord of the house. الَّذِي أَطْعَمَهُمْ مِنْ جُوعٍ وَآمَنَهُمْ مِنْ خَوْفٍ. Who has fed them, saving them from hunger, and made them safe, saving them from fear. The surah begins with لِإِلَاف. لِإِلَاف. What does لام mean? 4. It gives the meaning of تَعْلِيل, reason. And this surah is connected with the previous surah. In the previous surah, Surah Al-Fil, a huge favor of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was mentioned. Which favor? That how He defended His house. And in this surah, another huge favor is mentioned. This huge favor was especially on who? The Quraysh. The Quraysh. That favor was on not just the Quraysh, but the people of Makkah, not just the people of Makkah, but all of the Arabs, all of the people who came to the house of Allah and worshipped Allah there. And over here, specifically the Quraysh. So Allah says, لِإِلَافِ قُرَيْشِ. What does إِلَاف mean? إِلَاف is from the root letters, Hamza, Lam, Fa. Alf. What does Alf mean? 1,000. 1,000 is a big number where 1,000 things have come together. From the same root is ulfa. Ulfa is love. وَأَلَّفَ بَيْنَ قُلُوبِكُمْ. When people love one another, their hearts are united. They come together. And ilaf means al-jam' wa-dham. Ilaf means al-jam', together. Al-dham, to be united, to be collected together. So لِإِلَافِ قُرَيْشِ. For the ilaf of Quraysh. Ilaf of Quraysh, what does it refer to? It refers to, if you read the next ayah, ilafihim rihlat ash-shita'i was-sayf. Rihlat ash-shita'i was-sayf, this is describing what the ilaf is. So in other words, their ilaf is their trade. Their trade journeys. Because for that they would gather up. They wouldn't travel alone. No, they would travel how? In the form of caravans. They would travel in the form of caravans and they would travel to different places in order to do their business. And when they would come back, again they would be united with their families back into their city. So for the purpose of ilaf of Quraysh, meaning for the purpose of the trade of Quraysh, which trade, which business, which trade journeys, which caravan? Ilafihim, their trade, I'm going to do the figurative or the meant, the understood meaning in the context, the contextual meaning. Okay, ilaf literally means unity. However, over here, as I mentioned to you earlier, it refers to their tijara, because for tijara they would get together. For their tijara they would travel together. So which tijara? That rihlat ash-shita'i was-sayf. Rihla, from the root letters ra, ha, lam. By the way, just before we continue, there are many, many surahs of the Qur'an, many ayat which have multiple meanings, which can be understood in different ways. So if I'm giving you one meaning and you read something else elsewhere, or in the translation you read something else, don't think, oh, this doesn't make sense. If I'm giving you one meaning and it makes sense, that's it's relevant. There's many other meanings, but if I start telling you all of them, then we should be sitting here until Isha, probably even beyond, okay? If we want to complete the lesson. So there are many meanings, I'm just going to tell you one, because it's more relevant and it's easier to understand. And alhamdulillah, once a person wants to learn, then there's no limit to learning. Every time you open the book of Allah, every time you open a tafsir book, you learn something new. So don't think that just because you don't learn all the different meanings at one sitting in one point, you're not going to be able to learn them. Inshallah, open up your heart and open up your mind and ask Allah, and Allah will give you the tawfiq to learn again and again. So إِلَافِهِمْ رِحْلَةَ الشِّتَاءِ وَالصَّيْفِ. رِحْلَةَ رَاحَ لَمْ. رَحْلَ is used for camel saddle, and رِحْلَة is a journey, travel. It is to prepare for a journey and also to undertake the journey. So for their trade journeys, where would they travel to? When? In which season? Ash-shita, the winter. Was-sayf, as well as the summer. Remember that Makkah is a place where nothing grows. Ibrahim alayhi salam, what did he say when he left his family there? رَبَّنَا إِنِّي أَسْكَنْتُ مِنْ ذُرِّيَّتِي بِوَادٍ غَيْرِ ذِي زَرْعٍ. It's a valley that doesn't produce anything. Nothing at all grows here. It's a barren valley. And in Makkah is the house of Allah. Strange. Where do people generally live? Where there's food. But we see that despite the fact that there was no food in Makkah, yet people lived there. Why? Because of the house of Allah. Because of the house of Allah, that place was populated, it was heavily visited. Now the people who lived there, obviously they had to eat from somewhere. So what did they do? They were businessmen. They would travel on business trips in order to buy food and buy grains and different edible products, as well as clothes and so on and so forth, from different areas. And we see that in the winter, they would travel to Yemen. The Meccans, they would travel to Yemen. And in As-Sayf, in the summer, they would travel to Syria. So every year they would make two business trips, two big shopping trips. And they would go to Yemen in winter and Syria when? In the summer. So when they would go there, obviously they would go in safety, in security, and they would come back in safety and security with a lot of provision as well. So this huge favor Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is mentioning them over here, that look, the city that you live in doesn't grow anything. However, Allah has facilitated your rizq for you. How? That you travel to one place in one season, you travel to another place in the other season, and you travel in full security. When you go there, people respect you, because whenever they were traveling, nobody would harm them. Nobody would harm them, saying, these are the people of Makkah, these are the custodians of the Kaaba. Otherwise, no caravan, no traveler was safe in Arabia. No caravan was safe in Arabia. You're traveling, people will plunder, they will loot, they will attack, they will kill. But the Meccans, everyone had respect for. Why? Because they were the custodians of the Kaaba. And when they would go and do their trade, again, people would deal with them in a very good way. Why? Because they had come from Makkah. This is just like if there is a particular person from a country that you really look up to. Like for example, from the West, somebody goes to the East, like an Eastern country. They say, oh, you know, they've come from this country. They've come from this country. And all of a sudden they're like, yeah, I'll give you the best deal. I'll give you the most excellent deal. You know, try this. This is a gift from me. This is what people do. So the Meccans at home, they were very much respected. On their journeys, they enjoyed full security. And the places they were visiting, over there also they gained huge favors. All of this, why? Because of the house of Allah that was in Makkah. So Allah is saying over here that إِلَافِهِمْ رِحْلَةَ الشِّتَاءِ وَالصَّيْفِ. You travel in winter, you travel in summer, you travel in all seasons, and you're able to travel safely, and you reap so many benefits. فَلْيَعْبُدُوا رَبَّ هَذَا الْبَيْتِ. Let them worship the Lord of the house. فَلْيَعْبُدُوا. Because Allah has bestowed these favors on them exclusively, so they should also exclusively worship who? Allah. فَلْيَعْبُدُوا. And notice it hasn't been said فَلْيَعْبُدُوا اللَّهَ. What has been said? رَبَّ هَذَا الْبَيْتِ. They should worship the Lord of this house. What does this house refer to? The Kaaba. Why? Because whatever glory they enjoyed, whatever safety, security, financial ease, success they enjoyed, it was because of the house of Allah. So look at all of these benefits you enjoy. Why? Because of the house of Allah. So you should also worship the Lord of this house. Don't worship these idols. No, no. People don't respect you because of these idols. They respect you because of this house. So فَلْيَعْبُدُوا رَبَّ هَذَا الْبَيْتِ. We learn in the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that أَوَلَمْ يَرَوْا أَنَّا جَعَلْنَا حَرَمًا آمِنًا وَيُتَخَطَّفُ النَّاسُ مِنْ حَوْلِهِمْ. Surah Al-Ankabut, ayah 67. That have they not seen that we have made haram a place that is so secure, and the people who are around, people who live elsewhere, what happens to them? يُتَخَطَّفُ, they're being snatched away. Meaning they're killed, they're plundered, they're looted, all of a sudden their lives are destroyed, their business is destroyed, but the Makkans enjoy full security. Why? Because of the house of Allah. Therefore, فَلْيَعْبُدُوا رَبَّ هَذَا الْبَيْتِ, because He alone has favored them. الَّذِي أَطْعَمَهُمْ مِنْ جُوعٍ, the one who has fed them. الَّذِي أَطْعَمَهُمْ, the one who has fed them, given them food, providing them with every type of food they could desire. Because you see, they went in winter and they went in summer. And winter has its own produce and summer has its own produce as well. So, الَّذِي أَطْعَمَهُمْ مِنْ جُوعٍ, مِنْ جُوعٍ meaning against, in order to save them from hunger. Or min can be understood as after, ba'd. That in Makkah nothing grows, and if they weren't able to travel so easily, imagine they would suffer from hunger. So الَّذِي أَطْعَمَهُمْ مِنْ جُوعٍ وَآمَنَهُمْ مِنْ خَوْفٍ, and He has made them safe. آمَنَهُمْ, given them security against what? Against fear. Which fear? Fear of being attacked in Makkah. Fear of being attacked on their trade journeys. Fear of hunger. Fear of lack of provisions. So Allah has given them food and Allah has given them safety and security. So when Allah alone has given these blessings to you, أَفَلَا يَشْكُرُونَ, will they not be then grateful? And out of gratitude, worship Allah alone. Recitation. Food, not being hungry, and the blessing of safety and security. And we should remember these blessings in any place we are, whether it is Makkah or outside of Makkah, anywhere in this world. Yes, these blessings are exclusive to Makkah in some ways. However, we enjoy them today as well in different places. So it's an obligation on us that we remember the blessings of Allah, and out of remembering the blessings of Allah, out of thankfulness, out of gratitude, worship Allah. Ya ayyuhan nas, u'budu rabbakum. Because the Makkans are being told, this is why you should worship Allah. So similarly, we should also remember the blessings of Allah and thank Him for them and increase in our ibadah.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. So, related heart, and we read Surah Humazah. So I was saying, like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the fire will touch the heart. So heart, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has divided the heart into four sections. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has divided, nobody has divided. And one side, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is sending the pure blood. Huh? And the other side, the impure blood is coming. Who has done this for us? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, why? That His, if for example, there is no wall, no obstruction, nothing, all the bad and good blood will be mixed and the person will be in the hospital. Like you will be seriously ill and so many heart diseases. But subhanAllah, I was so surprised when I was reading about the arteries and the veins. In the veins, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has kept special valves, special doors for you. Like you can see here, there's special valves are being fit for you, that this pure blood should not be mixed with the impure blood. Who had made this for us? Everyone thinks like, okay, this is the body, we are taking advantage from this thing. But when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not mixing the pure blood to and with the impure blood just for us, for our like health, and like how we should do the good ibadah. So how we are mixing the bad and good things inside our heart by doing riba, by doing so many bad things, that we are just forgetting that the blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is, He is, imagine the tiny, tiny details that He has took care of us. If we will see the heart and the section and the way the muscles have been layered and layered, you will really cry and you will think like, oh Allah, I will not do this again. Just so I was saying, be careful of the things that we say and do, and always think about the blessings that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has kept in your heart in such a minor details, that my servant should live longer, happier, and nothing should come to him bad.
That's a very beautiful thing you've mentioned, that many times we don't even realize these blessings that are within ourselves, within our bodies, that we are surrounded with. We don't even notice them. And we don't even notice them, and yet our lives are full of these blessings. And what does Allah say? فَلْيَعْبُدُوا رَبَّ هَذَا الْبَيْتِ, I have given you so much, do my ibadah exclusively. And there are many, many blessings that Allah has given. including the blessing of Quran. This is also a huge blessing. Because huwa khayrun mimma yajma'un, it's better than all that people could gather. Everything that people could collect. We learned about alhaakum al-takathur. There are people who are striving to gain more and more of this dunya. They're trying to collect more and more. However, the best that a person could gain is the Quran. This is also a huge blessing. So when Allah has given a huge blessing to a servant, what should he do? What should he do? He should increase in his worship.
When Shaitan gives you the waswasa all the time of hunger and fear,
yes,
that is his first attack to the person. What I'm going to do? My kids will be hungry. And always mother or people, they are really feared about these things. Yes. And two things are very important here. Most of the people came to this country because of the security, because the fear in their country. So we should think inside that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is reassuring here. Whenever you feel this kind of fear of hunger and security, remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He's gonna take care of your problems, yes, and secure you, inshallah.
Very true. Very true. And when Allah has given such a beautiful place for a person to live in, where he enjoys security, where he enjoys so many blessings, that a person forgets what hunger is like. A person forgets what not having food is like. Literally, I mean, we forget that. You go back home and then you see the poor and then you're like, oh, there's something known as hunger and poverty. But in this country, alhamdulillah, because of so many blessings that are around us, we don't even, you know, remember what hardship is like. So, for this blessing, what should we do? Just enjoy, enjoy, enjoy? No, we should, out of this gratitude, worship Allah and also be grateful for this place and give the haqq of this place as well.
I was thinking, you mentioned that the Quraysh, like, people would just, you know, stay away from them with the awe that, you know, these are the custodians of the Kaaba. So we as Muslims, we're also blessed, right? And so I was thinking that if we stay on the path of Allah's pleasure, then Allah too will protect us and keep other people in awe of us Muslims, right? We have this respect, and us as hijabis, mashallah, like, we see, we're out in the streets, people are like, you know, these are respected people. And I see that, and I feel so proud to be a Muslim at that point, because I'm like, alhamdulillah, you know, like, Allah has given us this dignity and this respect as Muslims. And so I was just kind of wanting to link back to this ayah.
And the word Quraysh, a little bit of meaning of the word Quraysh, it is said that the word Quraysh, this is used for a group of qabail, a group of sub-tribes. It wasn't just one tribe, but it was a group of sub-tribes who were the descendants of Nadr ibn Kinana. And Quraysh, this is on the structure of Fu'ail, it's the tasghir of Qarsh. Tasghir meaning it's the diminutive, the shortened form of Qarsh. Just as from Ibn you have Bunay, similarly, from Qarsh you have Quraysh. And sometimes this tasghir, diminutive, this is done for the purpose of ta'zim as well. So Ibn Abbas, he said that Qarsh is a huge sea creature that the Arabs were familiar with, and whenever people would travel on the sea, it would overthrow their ships and would also eat other sea creatures. So basically, Qarsh symbolizes someone who is undefeatable, extremely powerful, and people were afraid of it. And this is how the Quraysh thought of themselves as well, that we are so powerful, we are so strong, no one can stand up against us. They considered themselves to be superior to all other tribes of Arabia. And the people of Quraysh, they lived in Makkah. There were many sub-tribes, and the Prophet ﷺ was also of them. So they in particular are being reminded of this blessing because they were honored. They were honored by the rest of the people of Makkah. They were honored by the Arabs. They were respected. So all of this respect you have is not just because of who you are, but because of the respect that Allah has given you. So don't become proud about it, but rather humble yourself before the one who has given you this respect. Just as when a person learns the deen, learns the Quran, then other people begin to have some kind of respect for him. So at that moment, at that point, a person should not feel proud of himself, rather he should realize that this is because of the deen of Allah. And that should make him more humble before Allah. Okay. Let's listen to the recitation again.
Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim.
لِإِيلَافِ قُرَيْشٍ إِيلَافِهِمْ رِحْلَةَ الشِّتَاءِ وَالصَّيْفِ فَلْيَعْبُدْ